So you've picked some keywords from the keyword planner, and you've learned how campaigns, ad groups, and keywords work together. Remember, a campaign is a set of ad groups, and an ad group is a set of keywords and ads. To start showing ads for your campaign, you'll need to write ads that are associated with those keywords. In this video, we'll go over some top tips on creating great ads. Before we jump in, though, let's explore what ads are and how they work with queries and keywords. If a search query is a question someone asks Google, think of the search results as the answers to that question. Then keywords are triggers for your ad to appear amongst those answers. When someone's search matches a keyword in your ad group, the keywords tell your ad to show. So when you're writing ads, remember to keep them related to the keywords that they're grouped with. For instance, let's say your account has an ad group named Flower Bouquet Kit. Within that ad group, you might have the keyword DIY Bouquet Kit. If you do, be sure your ads also mention DIY Bouquet Kit. It's best to write at least 3 ads per ad group. Different messages work with different people. The more ads you provide, the more likely you'll be able to show the right message. So let's write an ad together. Step 1, provide a final URL. The final URL is the actual page someone lands on after they click on your ad. This web page should be related to the keywords of your ad group, like say a page on your site with all the DIY kits you offer. Step 2, write headline 1. The headline 1 field is the first thing people see in your ad. Focus on writing the best headline possible, since this has the most potential to make a big difference in your performance. Then, try relating this to the ad group's theme and keywords. And why not make it catchy, too? Step 3, write headline 2. Headline 2 is separated by a dash from headline 1 in the ad. The best way to show value to someone is to think about their benefits and needs. You can highlight a benefit like free shipping, or your website's reliability with official site. Step 4, provide display paths. Your ad's display URL is the web page address that appears in your ad. This is an option to further connect your ad to a user's search, so that it's not just a totally forgettable collection of numbers and characters. Use the path fields to give people more information about where they'll go once they click. Step 5, write a description. Use the description field to tell someone more about your business. Why should they do business with you? Try to stick with one clear message here. If you have more than one thing to say, you can always create another ad or save that messaging for an ad extension, which we'll talk about later. Remember, keep what you say in your ad simple. Once you have keywords and ads, your ads can start showing in Google. But that's only part of the journey. Once your ads are live, you'll need to look at your data to see how your ads are meeting your goals and how you can do better. Check out our next video, Track Your Goals.